We're trying to find out what happened in the case of Yang Berhormat Datuk Hasanuddin. He applied for quarantine exemption for a trip between the 8th to the 12th of December. He went for an OIC meeting conference in Istanbul, Turkey, together with three other elected representatives. That exemption was approved because of the test and release protocol that we have for official travel. On the 22nd, he arrived on the 22nd, and the initial exemption was overridden because he was asked to do home quarantine. And that is the last correspondence that we had with him. On the 20th of December, CPRC KKM issued an email to Yang Berhormat Datuk Hasanuddin, who arrived on the 22nd, saying that we have approved his home surveillance order, home quarantine. So this is different. This is subsequent to the OIC exemption. So we are now investigating the case, seeing where he went. Did he go from Turkey onwards to Iran and Pakistan or wherever else he was? And why, upon receiving the HSO, the home surveillance order, on the 20th, he broke his quarantine. So we will be looking into this. But of course, if he did break his quarantine, we can only fine him 1,000.
His HSO is 7 days, is it?
Yes, his HSO is for 7 days. He's fully vaccinated.
Will you be, so do all international arrivals, regardless of country, do they get a digital tracker or is it a pink wristband?
No, there's a pink wristband and a digital tracker for high-risk countries, which you've added Saudi Arabia on today.